As a child, I came here to visit my grandparents. I remember awakening to the sound of cows lowing and the way the starched and iron sheets felt. I think I was marked by those sensory experiences as a child here. I have these vivid memories of that farm life. Most of the land around me has been in the same families for generations. When I moved here, there were a lot of aging farmers working their last years on their farms. One of the first things I did as an artist was chronicle their gardens and the way they lived on the land. Where one person lived, now 2,000 people live. The rawness of it now is heartbreaking, but it will heal in its own way. A lot of the first paintings explored the opulence of nature juxtaposed with these scraps of architecture. After a while, I found ways to paint the same world with free interpretation and color. A lot of the beauty is little, lichens, mosses, and stones. And then I like the big forms, the twisted dead trees echoed in the water. I want to dig deeper into the cellular level of stuff. All the thousands of hidden triangles and rectangles created when you look at the branches of a tree against the sky. That complexity is what I like to record and riff on. Making progress feels uncomfortable, but it's actually the discomfort of stepping forward. The work took a leap when I started backpacking. It exposed me to these places that are so extravagantly magical. It changed me forever. I come home from these expeditions with this library of images to draw from. They all are imbued with this deeply spiritual magic because they are the place we came from. If I'm all twisted up inside, if I get into the woods, there is a visceral sense of healing. The enormity of that outweighs all the dark stuff. The work is preachment for the environment. It's a way of reaching people who are removed from nature with drama, color, and emotion. I'm stealthily sensitizing them. It's a terrifying moment in the history of the world, but you can't dwell in that grief. You have to agitate for change and the raising of consciousness. Fear is a prison everybody inhabits. Consciously stepping out of it makes a whole bunch of difference. You drop a pebble and the ripples start rolling. And if it resonates and it's righteous, more pebbles will be dropped.